Okay, hello. This is part 4 of my Outer Wild series, so let's jump into it. Cannon, fire the probe. Slate. Good morning, Slate. It's night, actually. Have a little marshmallow, and then I'll head off. Poke, 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 poke in your eye. Okay. So the end of stream yesterday, I really didn't have any idea where I'd be going, but I got a shower idea. Okay. So I don't really know how to get around in here. I'm looking for like 3 things in Dark Bramble. It hit me. The signal scope. I'm looking for escape pod, the vessel, and feldspar. Those are all things I can detect with this. So I just need to be on the right signal as I go in there. I still don't know what's up with the space egg. Maybe I'll figure that out. But I'm gonna go in there, find a signal, and then go towards that signal. There it is. Fly me there, ship. I'm not sure what I'm going to go for first. I guess maybe the biggest, loudest signal. And if there is no signal, I got no clue. No clue at all. So hopefully, there's a signal. Okay, yeah, there's a signal. And hopefully that brings me towards air, because that was kind of a problem. Alright. Oh, really? Okay. Funny joke game. Alright, let's go towards this. I guess it makes sense for everything in here to be a light. I just hope it's actually not an anglerfish down here. It's in there. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Oh, wait, is it tangled up in these, like, roots, maybe? Ooh, I see something there. I see something. Got something here. That the escape? Oh, that's the escape pod. All right. The guy himself a little trail, it seems. Okay. Our escape pod crashed as we tried to flee this place, destroying our movement and communication capabilities in the process. Sekka. That's a new one. I guess they. Did these people survive? Did they make it out of here? We haven't seen them pop up anywhere else. We've held out as long as we could here, but this pod supply of breathable air is nearly depleted. And the anglerfish attack more and more frequently. Our best chance at survival is to return to the vessel, to either repair the damage or more probably await rescue. Sekka, is the message finished? The vessel's beacon is already growing fainter. It will be gone in a matter of hours. We need to leave here quickly. Vessel has been mortally injured. Emergency sequence activated. Awaiting departure from vessel. Now launching escape pod 3. Multiple collisions have altered pod's trajectory. Significant damage to pod detected. Navigation error, life support error, propulsion error. Oh. External environments. Scan complete. Gravity not detected. Breathable air not detected. Ultra life form detected. Potentially hostile. Verdict. Do not exit pod. Good. There's a new problem. Our equipment is detecting two distinct beacons from the vessel. But it isn't possible for the vessel to be in two different locations at the same time. What? That's gonna be a bitch to find them. I agree, but the beacons are exactly identical to each other. Perhaps if I had more time. We're nearly out of time already, Din. The vessel's beacon is quickly fading soon. It will be gone. We will be lost. We will follow the beacon whose source is nearest to us. Excuse me. I suppose that beacon is false. We likely don't have enough air to reach the farther of the two beacons, Din. The decision is made for us. We'll leave a trail of lights as we go. There's still a chance someone could hear our escape pod's distress signal. And a year later, I found it. They never use the escape hatch. Okay, so let's go this way. I got a half supply of air. 3 minutes oxygen left. I ran out of air last time, but I did get lost. What's that? Oh, it's one of those seeds. Oh, it's inside there. Any who come here search you for us. We followed one of the two beacons from the vessel to this place, but now we can go no further. It's almost too faint to hear now, but the vessel's beacon is still faintly emitting from within this thorny seed. Yet the opening is too small for even a single Nomai to fit through it. Our escape pod couldn't have flown through here. I don't understand how this could be possible. But this gruesome place seems able to manipulate space itself. Maybe this is our undoing. To be so close to the location of the vessel and still so far is difficult. Worse, the vessel's beacon is dying. Soon we'll be unable to hear it. There is nothing we can do now but try to perhaps find a way inside, or at least attempt to comprehend why this happened. My dearest hope is that the other escape pods were able to reach relative safety. Damn. Okay. That's bad. How do I get in there? I'm running out of air too. Sorry. Nope. So, their suits are different. They don't have color on them. That's interesting. There is the further beacon. Oh, that's the ship. Never mind. Okay then. Well, shit. I'm gonna run out of air in here. But I did find something, and my idea worked. Fish. That's so freaky. But I did pick up. Okay. So that seed that crashed into Timberhearth, I pick up the harmonica through it. And I did pick up harmonica in the planet, too. Slate, I think I found feldspar. I'm gonna go get him back. I hope. So maybe if I get to him, I'll figure out how to get inside of the seed? Three. Yeah. Okay. So I'm getting somewhere. And I think I need Felspar to tell me how to get inside the giant's deep core. So maybe I gotta go ask him personally. Take me there. Crash me into the sun, please. Ooh, it got toasty there for a second. Autopilot is deadly if you don't know what you're doing. It is also deadly if you do know what you're doing and make a slight mistake. Or if you just let it, like, go a little too far. You know what? Why don't I just take the ship in? I'll have unlimited air. I just need the signal scope. Oh shit! Okay. Yeah, I think I want to go in there on foot. I don't think flying a little ship is the way to go. But I will have air if I get to him, so that's one thing. Autopilot, go. Don't crash into the sun. Oh, I'm gonna crash into the sun. Damn it! Die within 60 seconds of waking up. Shit. Whoops. That's a good achievement. Slate, can you double check the autopilot for me? It just killed me in... I'm just gonna say in a dream. So, double check that. It's a better angle. Yep, that's better. Abandoned ship. I'm going down there. That's where I want to go. Okay. Oh. Okay, we're going to the center one first then. Oh. Well, this is kind of a dead end for me. This isn't another seed, because that would be bad. Oh, no, I'm here. Whoops. Oh my God, I'm here. Hey, dude, I found you. You're shorter than I imagined. What is in here? Oh. Interesting. Oh, good, you have fuel. Hey! Feldspar! Whoa, yeah! Where do you come from? No one's come here in, well, ever actually. That makes you the second Parthian to ever reach Dark Bramble after me, of course. Well done. Say, it's you. They made you an astronaut? And you haven't blown yourself up yet? Good for you. Yeah, Felspar, you're alive. You never were the brightest hatchling, were you? Hey, I made it here. Yeah, that's right. I'm alive. I've been camping here ever since my ship, crashed violently. Oh, this is a good story. I just finished exploring the core of Giant's Deep. I needed a new challenge, and none of us had ever been inside Dark Bramble, so I think, hey, let's give it a try. I've been cruising around for a while, I'm dodging the odd, massive, interdimensional vine bristling with thorns when I run into this huge anglerfish, the biggest I've ever seen. Pull a few stunts, trying to shake the thing off. Nothing too fancy. I'm going full speed when the fish clips me, knocks me into a vine, and, well, like I said, I crash blammo. On impact, my ship starts making noises. It's like it's coming apart from the inside, and I think, well, that ain't great. Sure enough, I barely get out of there before the electrical system starts sparking like crazy. It's either move fast or die unpleasantly, so I had to put a little distance between me and my poor ship. My poor fried ship. I camped out near where I crashed at first. I found the skeleton later. Great find. Would have been stupid not to use it. So I moved set up here and planted my emergency tree seeds. Been here ever since. Yeah, wow. Yeah, pretty much. Anyway, that's how it all went down, Hatchling. Story's over, but feel free to stay and enjoy the fire a while. Or don't. Fire's not going anywhere. Yeah, how did he get to Giant's Deep? Giant's Deep Core, huh? Ah, that was a wild one. But since you're asking, I gotta assume you haven't made it down there yourself yet, right? If I tell you how, it kind of feels like cheating. On a completely unrelated note, that sure was a big hollow vine my ship crashed into. Yep. Is that a clue? If I were you, I'd take a walk and see where it ends. You want to go to the tail end of the anglerfish skeleton here and look for a flickering light in the fog. It'll be my old ship. Path starts there. Interesting. Shouldn't I tell ground control to come get you? Oh yeah, sure, whenever you have the time. Frankly, I kind of like it out here. Quiet, peaceful-ish. You're a little young to understand, but it's a lot of pressure being the best that ever was. Been nice to have a break. Where should I explore? That's the spirit. Anywhere is good, but you should know that space is weird here. Intensely. Ever tried throwing your scout into one of these seeds? See there with that, with the little opening? It's just big enough to launch one through. Your scout tracker will tell you the scout is in two places at once. But I don't think that's wrong exactly, because space doesn't work right in here. That seed looks small, see? But inside it's bigger. That makes sense. So to find the vessel, I shoot my probe in, and then I go to where it says it is, when it's not in the seed. That's a good idea. I've had a lot of time to think about this, and my theory is space in Dark Bramble kind of expands as you go through each sphere. That's why it's bigger inside those seeds. Well, that's my theory. Keep that in mind while you're exploring Dark Bramble, and maybe you won't get lost inside forever. Good luck. I'm gonna go find a ship. Where did he say that was? That sure was a big hollow vine my ship crashed into. Yep. If I were you, I'd go take a walk and see where it ends. You want to go to the tail end of this anglerfish skeleton. Look for yourself. Look for the flickering lights in the fog. Okay. Flickering lights in the fog. Oh, there it is. go that way. Where am I? Gravity just started like pulling on me. What? 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 Am I outside of the planet? Oh shit, it's one of the jellyfish. Trip 4, entry number. I'm gonna say not 1. Crashes 3. Boring, crashes 0, a personal best. Whoa-ho! Never thought I'd see one of these beasties outside of Giant's Deep. They were awfully useful back there. Maybe a jellyfish could be useful here too. Berg, this thing tastes terrible. The outside is all rubbery and tough. Maybe that's because it insulates the jellyfish's insides from getting zapped by electricity? Right, I'm going inside the jellyfish's interior cavity to see if what's in there tastes any better. Ew. Gross, he's just like trying to eat it. Oh. Nope, the feldspar, do not eat this, even if you are dying. It would be too sad if this were the last thing you ever ate in this life. I guess these jellyfish are only useful for insulating from electricity again. Again, do not eat. Love, feldspar. Oh, I can get in. I think I get it. I can fly up inside the jellyfish, and then I'll be safe. That's the way out. I see. Okay. I knew Feldspar would tell me something. Okay. Now to die. Good to see he's having a good time there, though. Like, not really in danger. Doesn't really seem to be in need of rescuing. Doesn't really seem interested in it. I'm happy for the dude. He's shorter than I imagined he would be, though. Slate! I found Feldspar! I know where he is! I know how to get to him! He says he's alright. Don't go looking for him. Pretty much. Okay. So do I go to Giant's Deep or go back for the probe? Nope. Okay. Okay. I think I can take the ship here, so I'll have a supply of air. There's quantum moon shit I don't know about though. I might need to go back to the Tower of Quantum Knowledge, or I don't know. I kind of just sped through there because I got there at the end of the world. Go to Jellyfish Land. Okay, now to find the tornado spinning in the opposite direction. Oh, okay. How do I get it to turn off? Or wait, I gotta go in. I'm in. Yes. I'm a little bit hurt, but I'm okay. Okay. Nice. Let's put the ball here. Okay, cannon. Receiving data from probe 900318110. Visualize the current trajectory of probe. Gotcha. Whoa. Retrieving previous launch data from Ash Twins. total number of probe launches. Yep. Deep space anomaly matching all known criteria for the IV nurse found by probe. Oh, that was a few ones back. So they did find its location? Words. What does that mean? Retrieving stored coordinates from Ash Twin. Displaying coordinates for the Eye of the Universe. Oh shit! Okay, it's just gonna give me that. Cool. What is... whoop, over here? So we got Ash Twin. Yep, okay. Does have anything to say I don't already know about? I have exciting news, Privet. The Ashtwin project is almost prepared to receive the probe data from the orbital probe cannon. Ooh, I think this is new. Rambi is adding some finishing touches here, but she'll be finished soon. Are you in the orbital probe cannon well? We are. The statue here and the probe tracking module is ready to record each launch's flight trajectory and will automatically transmit all relevant data to you. On the other appendage, I'm now worried about this cannon's structural integrity and its crew's moral integrity. Why moral? Once the probe determines the location of the Eye of the Universe, I'll send an alert directly to you, Rami. Okay. What about this? Okay, I've been here. Okay. Imagine, Privet, the probe tracking module will be the first to know the coordinates of the Eye of the Universe. You'll be the first to see them. I am honored and terrified. You won't ask the orbital probe cannon to use so much power that it breaks, will you? Fret not, my nervous friend. We only need to fire the probe once. Anyway, so who minds if it compromises the orbital probe cannon's structural integrity slightly? I would mind, Mallow. I would mind, because we won't be capable of receiving our probe's data if the probe tracking module is destroyed. Okay. I think that's all here. I can kind of just die, right? Ooh. All this like coral shit. What is at the center of all this? It's like this weird coral formation. Ow. Okay. I am done diddly on here. Oh, it forced me out. It didn't, like... Interesting. So it's like an easy barrier to cut through. One way. Zap. All right, that's good progress. So I will need to. So I got the coordinates of the Eye of the Universe. Still can't get to Ashton Project. Okay, that's really good. So I could just straight up fly to the eye. I don't want to do that yet. I want to get to the vessel. So see what's up there. Coordinates of the eye aren't here. Okay. Yeah, time to go to the vessel. Actually, does the eye show up anywhere on the map? That's a satellite. Take me there. So I'm gonna take my ship to the distress beacon because I think it's safe enough there. And I won't run out of air, hopefully. Yeah, I'll try and get there in the ship first, and if I get gobbled up, I'll not use it next time. There it is. There we go. Nah, this is the right signal. Controls just yet, because those fish will eat me. They're just gonna make spooky noises. Yeah, I hear you. I hear you, guys. They're like assholes. You're dicks. If all right, they can't hear me. Cannot hear me from here. That is good. So I guess that must be their eggs. Okay. It's inside there. In I go. There it is. Cool. Maybe I'll figure out where these guys came from originally. Oh, good air. What is this? What does that do? Your ship works, guys. Oh. I think I need something to read here. They got like a manual on board. Oh, there's some writing. Do any know my clans whose vessels can hear this message? It's clear to us the universe is dying. There are fewer and fewer resources and safe places within space now. So my clan and I believe the best option is for all our clans to stay together. If you can reach the gloaming galaxy, we found that Blackrock's sun are fairly stable and life in the star system is comparatively thriving. We live in relative safety. If you prefer to continue exploring alone, you will be on your own. Kenna, we're making our way to you. It's good to hear from you, Bromi. We'll watch your vessel. Has anyone heard from Neem? His clan was on its way to our vessel, but they never arrived, and he hasn't sent any messages. I'm beginning to worry. That is unsettling. It reminds me of that old myth my grandfather used to tell, the disappearance of Eskall. I remember hearing that story as a child. One day, Eskall's vessel simply stopped responding. The other clans searched and searched, but found no trace. It was as if their missing friend had warped out of existence. That's no myth, friends. Eskall's clan existed, and their safety was real. And their story was real. What a curious event to have passed into myth. Our ancestors were told that story, our ancestors' ancestors were told that story when they were young. Are you sure it's true, Hysop? It was a very long time ago, but yes. My clan's ancestors searched for Eskall's clan for a long time, but in the end, none of them were ever seen again. It's the only time in our history a vessel has ever disappeared this way. Hysop, I hope you aren't comparing Eskall's story to my clan's vessel. Nee, my friend, we feared you were gone. Yeah, we aren't, but nearly we found trouble during our warp. The triple suns of the Bright Spark star system exploded, and it was only a lucky coincidence we weren't caught in the blast. We'll meet you soon, Kana. I'm relieved your clan is safe, Neem. It's good to hear your words. Any vessels nearby, remember to be extremely cautious of potentially unstable stars, which is most of them now. This is Eskall's vessel. Something went badly wrong during our warp, and our vessel is mortally wounded. We need help as quickly as possible. Our vessel appears to have has it fused with the local environment somehow? There are vines that are now part of the vessel. It's been torn apart from inside itself. We are abandoning our vessel. Any Nomai clans or space flight capable species receiving this message, I implore you, we need your help. Is this broken? Can anyone hear me? Our vessel is dying. We need immediate assistance. I wish someone else understand their language. I don't get this. Ooh, there's shit underneath. Recording now. I've never encountered anything like this. The signal the vessel is receiving appears to be older than the universe itself. This is our first contact with anything of this nature. Everyone prepare to warp immediately. Escal, wait. I need more time to send an outgoing message. Shouldn't we tell another clan where we're going? We can send the message upon our arrival. This extraordinary signal appeared suddenly. It may disappear just as quickly, and we can't lose a discovery this incredible. Focus on preparing for the warp instead. Felix, I understand. Anona, is the vessel ready to warp to the signal's approximate coordinates? The warp core is powered. This will be a significant jump. Afterward, we'll need time to recharge the core. That shouldn't create a problem, provided we arrive at or near the signal source. Everyone ready to warp. Interesting. Let's explore more of this ship while I have fuel. That's okay, I can get here. I guess I should probably stay inside here. That do. What does that do? Does that warp? This thing's broken. Is there a fixed one somewhere? Thank you. trying to see what this thing does. Okay, I guess it's time to die. See what I got on the ship's log. I know how to get back here if I need to. Use all the UC exhaustion in an ill-advised manner. Eh. I had unlimited there. Now I'm gonna use it in a bad manner. Okay. Get all kinds of achievements today. Die within 60 seconds. Use up all your air in a stupid way. Told Slade about suffocating enough, so I'm not gonna do it again. Okay, what did I discover? That's all. Okay. You know what? I probably can't decipher the coordinates yet, so I need to get here for it. So, Ash Twin. Anything talk about getting to the Ash Twin project? Advanced warp core. No physical entrances. So I think I need a warp there. I think that's what everything's pointing to. A way to warp there. So I guess I'm going to Ash Twin now. Let me check that. Nothing. Okay. As far as this doesn't like connect anywhere. At least I figured it out. Okay. So I'm gonna try and go from one of these warp towers, I guess. Actually, maybe I should go from Actually, I'm gonna go to the high energy lab and see if I missed anything there. Are landing. Oh yeah, where does that go? There's gilch matter there. That goes to the city. That's right there. Okay. Time to look for the gravity can, actually. That's the way in. That's the way in. This cable on in. Oh, right, I need to wait for that to fill up to pass. Righto. What I probably should have done up there is put a scout where that thing was. So maybe I could find that from over here, maybe. I don't know. I'm curious where that goes, and there must be something interesting there. A cool tool. Like a little like radio. Thank you. Wait. Oh, we can go up here. Right. I remember this being a bit of a maze. And it's stressful because the sand is rising and all that. It's super fun having to do this timed. There we go. Oh, that's where that is. Okay. So that's meant to be just a shortcut in here. But the damn ghost matter. It's being ghosty. Sesame. What? Wait, I can control the warp cores? So wait. Wait. Wait, I need to pause this to think, so. There's these seven warp cores here. I can pick them up. What did I do with them? There's three none, two black hole, two white hole, it looks. I haven't seen anything talking about a special warp core. There isn't one of these that stands out, though. I think I need to get to my ship, wherever that's parked. Because... Okay. I'm gonna... So there were seven, but there's five towers, so... One could be Whitehall Station, the other could be Blackhall Station? No. So. Black holes go to white holes. I don't know, I don't understand the empty ones. I don't know what we do with the empty ones. Like, if I just swap this, what happens? Does that change things? Like, can I do that and it just does something? Me. Yeah, orchestra. Yeah. Reproduce negative amount of time elapsed. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I've read that. Wait. Wait. is even in here, though? So what did that do? So I'm sending... see me through the cracks, I guess. So... okay, I switched power to go to that, as opposed to whatever it was. Use the time only. Try adding more energy. So I don't know what that's doing. Wait. Okay, I'm putting it together. So, if I do... no. If I do that... no, I need a black hole and a white hole. So... what is that telling me, though? Like, yeah, I know that's how it works because I've been to Brittle Hollow. There's nothing. Two things, no. I don't get this. There's talks about a special warp core. What if I turn the power off? So will this still work? Wait, is it the fact that it... is it demonstrating the time thing? Because the... yeah, because this is faster. It's coming out before it goes in, even. It's like a half a second faster. create a 22-minute interval is possible. That is to have something arrive 22 minutes before it's actually sent through the warp. Can I do the 22-minute, like, time interval thing? Talk about towers. So I'm so okay, so up there is one solar panel. On the other twin, there's two that are way bigger. Is that enough power? Well, then how do I hook up power? No, wait, it's constantly getting power because it's... so those solar panels are constantly powering the project that's in the core there. This shit here isn't connected because there's no like cable running between the planets, just the sand. So what do I do about that? How do I warp to it? I'm not sure I've discovered something, but just kind of walked past that the first time I was here. I'm gonna start filling up with sand soon. Oh, it already has. Well. I think that's the end of that for this go. I guess I'm gonna die. So I'm kinda lost now. I guess I just need to think. There. So I need to find the warp into the center of Ash Twin. I don't know where that would be. Possibly the Forge? Maybe? That seems central, and I don't... Have I done everything that's there? Slate, I'm confused. I figured out a lot, but I'm confused right now. I'll, think, I guess. figure anything out? No. So, Black Hole Forge. Called it from the quantum moon. Warp's tower alignment point. Okay, that tells me all about aligning stuff so I can warp to other planets. On or in a close orbit around the relevant astral body. Our last twins are close enough together, they function as a single astral body with a shared alignment point between them. So does that mean if I warp to them from somewhere else, I'm just as likely to get either of them? So it's kind of a crapshoot. All the warp guards were being constructed on Ashwin. All the six warp receivers being constructed in different locations. So, there's five towers and six receivers. So the six receivers underground. That's one. Yeah, so five towers. I guess that would be the sixth one. They're on the sun. Trials. Miss Mortar, we're at Whitehall Station? Maybe that's the way in. I'm gonna go there. Interloper's gonna be hanging out there. Wherever it is. Or I could just crash into. Yeah, you know what's more fun? Go in here and go through the black hole. That'll be easier to locate. this planet. Bump. Alright, down we go. Okay. So now there's gotta be more here. Whoops. So I've aligned it with Brittle Hollow to get back there. Can I align it with other places? So like if I can't pick that up. But I got this. Can I, like, is that Brittle Hollow specifically? Line up eventually. Can I make it line up with something else? I know I can make it line up, actually. So what if I do that? Or does it just make this spin? I think it just makes this spin. So it'll spin until I warp. Can I get it to warp me somewhere else? Projection stone here. There's nothing to put this on. Whoa, shit. I didn't want that. Guess I'm gonna jump in a black hole again. Ooh! That hurt. I'm not used to high gravity here. Oh shit, that's the observatory. That's my ticket to the black hole. There we go. Back in my ship. Okay. So it says there's more here. I don't know what else there is. I don't see anything. It's cool that it's spinning right there. But I don't get it. I just don't get what else there is here. Shit. Like, I think this could help me warp to I think it could get me into the place, into the Ash Twin. Is it here actually? Whitehall Station. Every node of my warp tower is tuned to a specific astral body. To use a tower, you must be standing on the warp platform during the tower's alignment with its corresponding astral body. The alignment happens when the astral body is directly overhead. Yeah. So that this station takes you here. Observed a temporal anomaly at the Whitehall Station. Increased negative time interval between Arrival and departure. By adding energy to the warp cores. 2 minute negative interval. Negative time interval is possible. And concluded it would require new technology to produce the necessary energy as well as an advanced warp core to handle those energies. Ash Twin was proposed as a location for the project. Oh, so that's what links it to that. So, I guess let's go to the sandy one. Sand to go down to stand on the one tower I didn't try out yet. Oh, I'm gonna crash into the sun, damn it! Okay, sleep. I'm gonna take a nap for a little bit. I'm gonna wait a few minutes for whatever sandy planet to have a sand go down a little bit so I can use one of its towers. I don't really know what to try after that. I guess, I think what I need to learn more of there is I need to find the right warp tower. But if I like go through everything, I don't. Problem is these, no mind never said which tower would take you there. So, like, I have no idea which one it is. I know that. Oh my god. See, I just don't know which tower to go to. So I think I need to go to one of these towers. When I did all the towers, one of them never lined up. So, and I got sucked up, so. This is the one that I stood on, and it worked. guess I'll stand here and wait for it to align with something. But I'm standing on the planet that I need it to align with, so I'm super confused. Like, maybe it just can't be on this planet? Man, I just don't know. If so, I'm thinking now where I need a warp from can't be on this planet. It's got to be somewhere else, but I have no idea where else, because what else has these towers? Only other place that has a tower is the station, and I was just there, and that only warps to back to Brittle Hollow. Take me, sands. Take me. Finish me off. Fill me. Fill my lungs with sand. Okay. So I think the information I need is technically from the station. But there's that little, like, table thing. The little, like, stone projection. But there's no, like, project thing for it. So I need to, like, pick that up and take it somewhere, I guess? But I thought I'd done that before and it didn't do anything. So maybe I need to take that and... Where the hell is this place? There. You know what? Brittle Hollow. Brittle Hollow. I'm going there. I'm taking the shortcut. So, shit, where's one of those things that's easy to get to? Probably Giant's Deep, to be honest. That might be one of the easiest ones. Perfect. Okay, so I want this. Okay. Get this little stone tablet. So now I'm gonna take it to Giant's Deep. There it is. Alright, I can fly there. If I don't hit Bramble or Brittle Hollow, it'd be crazy if I hit the Interloper. Crash right in. That mystery will slow me down. Whoa, okay. Just my luck. Let's go back in again. Okay. I need specific island here. Not that one. Even though I could have what I'm looking for. Was the one. I guess I'll wait for it to fall back down. Hopefully not on top of me. Oh, there it goes. Fuel. Okay. So now. It's a cool little model there. Okay, so I need to get over here. Thank you. tell me your secrets, wall. Nothing. What is this show, at least? That shows that, so it leads directly there. But it doesn't say anything about it. It's like, that's what confused me, because this says something. We're all broken. Yep. Which part is this? Alright, it's the one that's intact. So what is up with this one? Maybe I need to take this to the station. Or not the station, the actual Brittle Hollow. And have it looked at, maybe? So where can I have it look? God, I'm gonna crash into Giant's Deep. Shit. Damn it. Alright, let's try that again. So, I think... I think you're gonna be somewhere under the North Pole where I can have this looked at, maybe? Because you're gonna land right here if you come back this way. This is what I think I need. Well, not exactly, but I think I need this. Yes! Yes! Maybe and I reviewed the records you sent. Look. And they appear to show Nomai arriving at the warp received from Brittle Hollow slightly before departing from Whitehall Station. I understand it's exceedingly odd, but Clary and I have tested and retested the equipment, and the result is the same every time someone warps. The interval is incredibly minuscule, roughly 1/100,000th of a second. Do you suppose our instruments can't accurately measure time to such a small degree? As I've already told Raimi, these measurements can't be accurate. How can a Nomai arrive on Brittle Hollow before he or she ever stepped into the teleporter? The implications are absurd. think I've read this already. I don't disagree. It would mean I've inadvertently broken several fundamental theories regarding the universe. We would have to reconsider all our beliefs about the nature of time. Yes, I hope so too. Poke is pie. Pie is confident that reading. Confident the reading is inaccurate. She's kindly helping me attempt to recreate this phenomenon at the high energy lab. We're designing an experiment to make more data. Update Poke. The high energy lab is in the canyon on Ember Twin's equator. Come here at once. You need to see this. There we go. I've never read that before. So ship log updated. Which I have been to all that. So that just kind of tells me more. So I've discovered everything there. So I destruct, yep. An advanced warp core was approved for installation in the central chamber of Ash Twin. They talked about going back to the vessel for their warp core. Vessel's warp core is long dead. I created a three-sided pillar on the bridge. It appears to be some sort of input device. Then we tried to call for help. The vessel's outgoing message system broke during the crash. The vessel can still hear incoming messages from other Nomai vessels. The remaining Nomai clans are regrouping in response to the impending death of the universe. I found a recording of the original signal the Nomai encountered from the Eye of the Universe. The Nomai were worried the signal might disappear, so they worked before they could tell another clan where they were going. So sixth location. Remember this final world. To explore the sixth location, the shrine must be on the moon's north pole. So I still don't know what the sixth location is for the quantum moon. This may, like, tell me how to get in? So I don't know how to get in here. That's the thing. Five towers. One doesn't seem to do anything. But the other one warps you back or something? So where is there more for me to learn? Because I feel like I'm at two dead ends here. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1 location, 2 location, 3 location, 4 location, 5 location. There's nothing else in like the system anywhere that it would go to. Inside the planet, obviously. So these are just kind of a way to get from one planet to another. I don't really need those for anything. They are interesting in where they have their shuttles located, but I could just fly to those places for the quantum moon. It's everything there. So like, I've got. I might need to go back to the Tower of Quantum Knowledge. Like, I still don't see any way of getting there, really. Got Dark Bramble, Giant's Deep, Brittle Hollow, Timber Hearth, Twins. I think I might need to get in here again. What's my time looking like? Check the hourglass. Probably about half on time. And I can go back down there and look, but it seems like I can't get in there unless this is falling through the black hole because the floor is broken. And this acts like it's supposed to tell me everything I need to know before I go to the quantum moon. So, like, I can't get up from here. Whoa. Ground is too high for me to fly up over. Ow. I'm painful. If I fall, there's the black hole. So I am kind of lost now. It seems like they discovered the sixth location eventually. And it seems like it's the eye of the universe they came here looking for. Which just kind of makes sense. Where's my ship? Oh, there's my ship. I think I'm sticking on another planet chunk. So that it won't crush me, because it crushed me one time. So I put it here. It'll just kind of fall through whenever this does. It won't be on top of me. So. I'll just try and hang out here, figure out this place. Oh, down we go. All right, let me. Whoop. Take long. So I don't think I have long before the system dies. Whoop. Before the game resets. There we go. I think I need to go here, but I don't have a thingy here. So maybe I go up here and look around? It's a scroll. I don't know if I read this one. I put that away? No, I put it. I got it. Okay. I'm gonna rearrange this. Welcome, Selena. Your arrival here means you've completed your preparation on Giant's Deep. You're ready to depart for the Quantum Moon. Yep. On your pilgrimage, the Quantum Moon will carry you, just as it carried me and many in our clan before me, to the Moon's sixth and most secret location. You'll be aided in your pilgrimage by the shrine your clan built on the Quantum Moon, but remember this final rule. To explore the sixth location, the shrine must be on the Moon's North Pole. Yeah, I know that. Got it from here. Be curious on your journey. So, I need to put this thing down, I guess. Drop. I need to pick that up. Drop that. Take this with me. Alright, I don't think I read this. If you're here to make your first pilgrimage to the Quantum Moon, you're almost prepared to set out on this deeply significant journey. Before you do, pause and remember your history. We make this journey not only for ourselves, but also to honor the members of our clan who came before us. Those who, after the crash that brought them to the star system, became stranded on Brittle Hollow and in between, with no communication between these two groups of survivors. These Nomai looked upward from the two different planets and saw the same wandering moon visiting their skies. It was this moon, the Quantum Moon, that kept their curiosity alive during this long period of hardship. After the two divided groups were able to reunite, it became our clan's united goal to find and visit the Quantum Moon. This took time, and many Nomai who dreamed of seeing the Quantum Moon died before we discovered how to make the journey. When you reach the Quantum Moon, recall these Nomai and carry their curiosity onward with you. Okay. Oh, there's a second place for a scroll here. Okay, so yeah. There's no like tablet or anything here, it seems. I did find something new, I guess. I just don't really know what in comparison. Alright, I'm gonna fly into the sun. Sun. I'm flying towards you. Maybe faster if I used up my fuel in the air than fly to the sun. don't know. It seems kind of slow going. Yeah, who needs fuel? I'm going to the sun. I'm going to the sun. Give me your warmth, sun. Roasted. Okay. I don't really know what that told me that it didn't know. Like that it took many generations for them to figure it out. I'm not really sure. Sleep, you have any ideas? No, you sat here the whole time and roasted marshmallows. Of course you don't. Farts. Let me see what I learned, at least. Anything? Oh, okay. It's deeply significant for the Nomai. The two groups of Nomai turned out in between a brutal hollow where became their united goal to find and visit the Quantum Moon. Gotcha. Yeah, so yeah, they built that after their underground city. You know, there's probably stuff in those buildings that I didn't check out. Over here. There it is. Guess I'll see what I can figure out about that gravity cannon. That's the one dude's camp. Go. There's a landing spot. Thud. What is this? What is this show? Oh, that's in here to the tower. Okay. Ooh, can I take this to the tower? Oh wait, I can have it right here. So I think I might have missed reading a few of these because I didn't notice that. I'm at the shuttle. I'm ready to make my first pilgrimage to the Quantum Moon. That's exciting. You're almost ready, but there's still one more rule you need to learn. Come see me at the Tower of Quantum Knowledge. The Terra is on the opposite side of Brittle Hollow. If you follow the path west to the crossroads, you can reach the tower from there. My gratitude for the directions. Bells, I'll see you soon. Okay, that's just directions there. Shit down there. Okay, I'll try and get that building. Roads. Shadow's currently resting on the quantum moon. Activate gravity cannon. Call the shuttle home. What if I standed there while it's activated? Will that launch me without a ship? Crossroads. Very musical. Oh shit, it will. Funny. Where am I going? Okay, I think I would have gotten boosted. So. Hello. Towards it. It probably won't let me. Oh, interesting. It gave me air. Alright, I'm gonna just crash into this planet. Catch me! Gravity cannon works without the shuttle. So you can totally fling yourself off into space with it. That's funny. That's about what I expected, so. What else to do? What else to do? I gotta teleport here. No, let's. I'm gonna check out that shell. Maybe there's something on there. I'm surprised the shrine hasn't been mentioned until now. Let's see what that shuttle says again. I know I looked at it a few days ago. Shit, I feel like I'm missing something here. Okay, let's landy do right here. Thump. Hop on out. And if I call it back. I just fired off. Doesn't say anything. Okay. Come back here. I guess I'm gonna jump inside of it and see if I missed something, I guess. I must have. I've also never been in this part of the building. Which just has. Okay, I have been here. That's just a way up. Whoa, shit. Excuse me, so the warp core there. In South Pole. Okay, so the shrines are in North Pole, but it takes, when you land there, you always land on the south. God, no. I don't want to land there. Warp me back, warp me back, warp me back! These things are like tape recorders. That's interesting. So So there's really like nothing there except for like a clue. Like it takes you to the south and then go north when I'm there. The moon. Do I have to? So do I have to force it back here and then I warp to it? That the only way to get there? There it is. Oh, but is it the twins now? What the hell? What's there? There it is. So I think it's got the secret six location so that I can't, like, on the map, like, really keep track of it. So, like, it's gonna. If I try and do what I'm doing now, it's gonna like not show up anywhere if I have every planet in. If I have every planet in, what's it called? Every planet in view. But the thing teleports so much that I can't really like keep track of it. So I don't really know what to do here. To do. I'm so lost now. I've done like 90% of the game, I feel like, but now, like, the last like two things I don't know how to get to. And I've read everything that's like, yep, you say you would get to it. And like, I've got these vague clues, so like, the shrine under the North Pole. You'll land on the South Pole when you get there. And then, like, you've gotta warp to the planet core. But I don't really have any idea where to warp from. Basically seal off the core, yeah. So it's just the alignment angle between a warp tower and its corresponding astral body. Warp tower alignment angles are not exact. Okay, that gives me some wiggle room. port. So. It's like this, I think it tells me if I warp to them, it could be either or. But I've warped here. All towers are being constructed on Ash Twin. All the 6 warp receivers are being constructed at their different locations. Fuck. I'm so lost. I don't know. I found everything else. Everything. I went and found the missing guy and the ships. What did this like secret test on the giant planet? I don't know about this either. This makes no sense. Like, this links back to that. Okay, yeah, that's how that connects. It's like, I don't know what to do. Like, everything else I missed, it's like, made sense, and I just had to think about it. But this... I have, like, nothing. I have, like, nothing here, and I don't even know where to look if that information is not somewhere I've already been. Which is really annoying. Like, it's acting like, alright, you can go on to the quantum moon now. Just make sure the thing's on the North Pole so you know what to do. But like, I don't know what to do, and I feel like it's not my fault that I don't know what to do now. I really just feel lost right now. I'm going to look around the moon, I guess, Edelrock. That little dial up there may be like some kind of clue. It's interesting, but I think I've, like, there's just the one, like, audio log thing here. Then this, I've done this, maybe if I come back. This is kind of about the quantum moon some more. And it's like that they can't, or no, that they can't track, this. But they can track, like, the other places. Yeah, so it's like a, like, space navigator. There's the eye. Wait, does all this spin? So wait, what's that? The sun? I think that would be the sun. Yep, the sun. Good thing they had a thing to keep track of that, because you might lose it. So then this. Does this just constantly... No, it doesn't. It's outside the spins. So this guy's keeping track of the other astronauts. Today I thought I heard something strange. I don't know. There's probably nothing. Something strange coming in from Timber Hearth. Oh, so that's a hint. So he's picking up, like, he's picking up that when really, like, it's also coming from there. I can't tell but feldspar. See, I just don't know what to do next. Like a walkway that spirals up. That's interesting. Gravity's fucking weird. Whoop! Especially on smaller objects like this. It's like this is like a perfect like right angle to what's down there. But it kind of acts as like a cliff edge. That's some cool shit. So then this is like. This works. But then when I'm like down here, it's just kind of above. But if I'm here, I fall down. Which is super trippy. Okay. I guess... that forever confused. Am I maybe missing something from the mines? Oh shit. 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 Uh-oh. Oh my god. What? Did they witness us, like, evolving? After closer observation, mining site 2A wouldn't be safe for the native life dwelling in some of this cave's pools. So unfortunately, we'll have to mine one of the other sites. On the opposite hand, new life. This species is semi-aquatic, very hardy. The ecosystem here is quite robust, so I believe they'll thrive in the long run. Be cautious near the pools if you visit 2A to meet them. I was watching them once during a rest, and the hours escaped from me. They're fascinating. I wonder what their fourth eye does. It probably sees. There are a few cave sites that look promising. What about site 2B? It shows similar formations and strata. This sounds promising. Will you and your mentor investigate? If mining site 2B proves safe for this native species, we'll move our work there. Site 2B is safe, Kolia says. We'll continue to monitor our activity and its effect on life here. That's the geysers. That's cool. Oh, shit. Oh, bye-bye, shit. Sounds looking real bad right now. Okay. So I think there's more down here in these caves. Sploosh. Oh, I didn't read that. You remind me of a subterranean species that my mentor, Morail, once told me about from when our clan used to travel across this universe. I imagine she would have enjoyed these life forms greatly. Look like little frogs look things. But I want to go here. Oh, this is under the town. That will take me back up. Okay, I think that would have brought me back in a circle. Back to my ship, I think. One of the geysers didn't get me first. Sure where I am. This leads back to the ship, so yeah, I'm back here. Okay. This is interesting. But shit, this is what belongs in the museum. Site. Okay. Well, damn. I'm still lost. I don't know. I just don't know. I'm a little frustrated. Let me check the ship's log. See if something was added there. Nothing new. So, shit. I think I'll end it here. I'll take some time to look into getting here, and try not to be spoiled. But I think if it's not written out here, I've kind of pieced it together. I've talked about it on stream here, so I don't imagine it'd be anything too spoily, other than like what's here, and I've pretty much seen what's here. So, I think I'll end it here. This bit short, but it's been going about 3 hours. So, if you enjoyed this, please follow here on Twitch, on YouTube. Please like and sub, please. And we'll probably, I don't know. Maybe I'll finish this. Tomorrow, we will see. Let's blast that. All right, see you all tomorrow.